Erin and Matt, looking at your families and around this chapel and beyond, you are surrounded by substantial and at times heroic examples of the constancy upon which we would appropriately reflect today, the day of your wedding.
I was in Indiana, and I saw Matt's parents there, and I had yet to meet Erin, and Mrs. LaFortune joked that Matt could not get married until I approved of his girlfriend. About 6 months later, I found myself in D.C., finally met Erin. 2 days later, Matt proposed to Erin. So I'm not saying that my approval is the reason we're all here today, but you're all welcome. Yeah.
When we see and know Erin, we see one who shares a breadth of experience and capabilities, who shares wisdom and brilliance, generosity, and an enlightened sense of other-centeredness in ways that remind us of our best selves. If this marriage is to be a vivid reflection of Christ alive in the world, your life will be a revelation of what is God-like, with characteristics such as compassion, patience, forgiveness. Forgiveness will only enhance the trust that you have with each other, a cornerstone of genuine intimacy. Such merciful trust may just serve as the cornerstone to your dynamic relationship as husband and wife. Last evening, I heard from at least three people who said Matt and Erin are perfect for each other. I think collectively, we would say Matt and Erin deserve each other.
I've known Matt since I was 2 years old. And he's really been an older brother in my life. I can say he's been a huge influence on my life as well. For example, when I was in middle school, I had to write an essay about a role model in my life. And sorry, Mom and Dad, I wrote about Matt. Yeah, so.
In light of so much darkness in the world, the two of you illuminate hope. And you do that by who you are and who you will be together. Such identity is a profound response to an ongoing gospel message. Because you've been loved, in turn you love each other and allow that gift to spread beyond yourselves. I, Erin, take you, Matthew.
I, Erin, take you, Matthew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Really though, Matt is a very kind, passionate, and intelligent man. It's been my pleasure to get to call him my best friend for the last 20 years. And while I haven't gotten to spend as much time with Erin and Matt together as a couple, I can tell you from the times I've shared with them, if their marriage is anything like the sangria that Erin makes, they're going to have a wonderful marriage. Yeah, so.
So we who gather here this afternoon do so in gratitude for you and for your marriage. We extend our prayerful support in telling you how proud we are to stand with you today.
Has already been so welcoming and is equally in kind and intelligent, and I can tell by the way they treat each other they're going to have a long and wonderful marriage. And so obviously, to finish off, Matt did not need my approval before he proposed to Erin, but even if he did, it would have taken about 10 seconds into meeting her that he had gotten beyond lucky. So cheers to Matt and Erin.
Today, you commit to one and to the openness of the other among a humanity that needs a great deal of such strength.